Many years ago, I created a ticket invite for Inkie's cake party in Inkpad. Following on from that video, I thought it would be fun to show off my shiny new Cricut maker and bring Inkie's ticket invite to life. If you haven't seen the original video for creating the ticket invite, I will link to it in the description below. I will also make the Inkpad file available so you can follow along without creating your own invite. All fonts used are system fonts and will be available on your iPad, so you'll have no problems loading it up. As I want to export my file as an SVG, then print and cut it on my Cricut, there are a few changes I need to make to my vectors. So, the first thing I like to do is duplicate my file. This is done by simply opening the Share menu up here in the top right and tapping Duplicate Drawing. Your new drawing will open and a number will be added to your file name. Now my original file is all safe, I'm going to convert all the text to outlines. To do this, select each block of text, one at a time, and from the Path menu, use Create Outlines from Text down at the bottom. There are several reasons I do this. The first is the SVG file format does not support text on a path, which is used for the date. The other is a personal preference, because if I have used a font that is not installed in Design Space, it won't matter. Now all my text is safely converted, I want to prepare my invite to be able to print before cutting it out. The lines I use to create my dividers are paths with a stroke width. If I zoom in, you can see the thin line, which is my path. Design Space will not recognise the line width, which is fine if I wanted to draw my lines, but I want to print them. To fix this, I want to select my divider lines and use Outline Stroke from the Path menu. Now you can see my line has become a closed path with a fill. Like my text, creating outlines will make it fiddlier to change the line width, so it's handy to have the original file kept nice and safe. Finally, I need to edit my ticket outline. I'm going to turn off the drop shadow, as it's no longer needed. I'm also going to change my fill colour to white. As I'm going to print my invite on coloured paper, I don't want my printer trying to print this beige colour. You can edit the colour in Design Space, but I prefer to do it in Inkpad. Okay, that's my file all prepared. I can open the export option in the top right and choose Export as SVG and save it up in the cloud. Over in Design Space, I can import my SVG, give it a name and hit Save. I'm ready to insert it on my canvas. All I now need to do is keep all my layers selected and use Flatten, which will magically sort out my print and cut for me. I'll change the size of my ticket so it actually fits on a piece of paper. Now I'm all set to make it, and by the magic of video, you are now invited to Inkie's cake party. My printer is able to print on quite thick paper. If you need to print on thinner paper, you could always stick your printed invite onto matching card before you cut it out to give it a bit of weight. I've also made a little envelope to hold my tickets and converted one of my favourite fonts to a single line font for writing with my Cricut. And there you go, Inkie's all ready to invite her friends to her little party.